Today we are doing problems on Bayes theorem. Let us consider a question. What is the probability of drawing a white ball from an urn containing 2 white and 4 black balls after having been transferred to it? 2 balls drawn at random from an urn containing 3 white and 5 black balls. That is, from an urn containing 3 white and 5 black balls, let us consider it as urn 1. 2 balls are transferred to an urn containing 2 white and 4 black balls. And from this urn, that means urn 2, a ball is drawn and it is a white ball. We have to obtain the probability of this white ball. One white ball is drawn from this urn. Okay. So that from urn 2, that is, we want to obtain the probability of a white ball from urn 2. So, as 2 balls are transferred from 1 to 2, there are 3 possibilities that 2 white may be transferred, 2 black may be transferred, or 1 white and 1 black ball may be transferred. Okay. So, let us consider these 3 events as A1, A2, A3. A1, 2 white balls. 2 white balls are transferred from 1 to 2. From 1 to 2, A2 means 2 black balls are transferred, 2 black balls are transferred from 1 to 2. A3 means 1 black, 1 white and 1 black balls are transferred from 1 to 2. Okay, there are 3 possible alternative cases and B be the event that drawing one white ball from 2. Okay, and required to find P of B, isn't it? What is the probability of drawing a white ball? Means P of B is required. Okay, by total probability rule, we can obtain P of B as equal to sigma I equal to 1 to 3 P of B, P of EI into P of B given EI by total probability rule. Okay, let us consider once again A1 as 2 white balls, A2 as 2 black balls, A3 as 1 white, 1 black. A1 as 2 white, A2 as 2 black and A3 as 1 white, 1 black. Okay, now we move on to the probabilities, that is P of E1 as equal to 2 white balls are transferred. P of E1 as equal to from 3 white to 2 white. Okay, that is 3C2 divided by the total 8C2. 3C2 divided by the total 8C2. That is equal to 3 by 28. P of A1 as equal to 3 by 28 and P of A2 as equal to transferring 2 black, that is 5C2 divided by 8C2. 5C2 divided by 8C2 is 10 by 28. P of A2 is 10 by 28 and P of A3 is transferring 1 white and 1 black, that is 3C1 into 5C1 divided by 8C2, which is equal to 15 by 28 as P of A3, 15 by 28. Now P of B under these cases. So that A1 implies 2 white balls are transferred. That is A1 implies urn 2 contains 2 white balls are transferred. So that 4 white and 4 black. Okay. A1 implies 2 white balls in excess here. And A2 means 2 black. black balls in excess here. That is 2 white and 6 black. A3 means 1 white, A1 white and 1 black. That is A3 implies 2 contains. What about 3 white and 5 black, isn't it? A1 means 2 white are in excess, so that 4 white and 4 black. A2 means 2 black, so that 2 white and 6 black. A3 means 3 white and 5 black. So under these cases of drawing 1 white ball, that is probability of B given E1 as 4 by 8. Probability of B given A2 is 2 by 8 and P of B given A3 is 3 by 8. Okay, 3 by 8. Okay, isn't it? 2 A1 means 4 white, 4 black. So drawing 1 white ball, so 4 by 8. A2 means 2 white, 6 black. So drawing 1 white ball means 2 by 8 probability. A3 means 3 white and 5 black. So drawing a white ball means 3 by 8 is the probability. So now by total probability rule, P of B equal to sigma I equal to 1 to 3 P of EI into P of B given EI. That is, this white ball may be obtained either by A1 or by A2 or either by A1 or A2 or A3. So sigma I equal to 1 to 3 P of AI into section B becomes sigma I equal to 1 to 3 P of AI into P of B given AI. So what is it? That is P of B equal to, that is P of B equal to P of A1 means 3 by 28 into P of B given A1 means 4 by 8. Plus P of A2 means 10 by 28 into P of B given A2 means 2 by 8. Plus P of A3 means 15 by 28 into P of B given A3 means 3 by 8. So on simplification, the answer is, it is equal to 0.334. Okay, on simplification, it is 0.344. Okay, on simplification, this becomes 0.344. Okay, so let us move on to the next problem. That is problem number 20. So, the last problem on Bayes' theorem, okay, the problem is, there are 3 urns with marbles of various colors are given. Urn 1, 10 white, 6 red, 4 black. 1, 10 white, 6 red, 4 black. 2 means urn 2, 12 white, 4 red, 4 black. And 3 means 8 white, 7 red, 5 black. Okay. Then 2 fair coins are chosen. 2 fair coins are chosen. If both are heads, on 1 is chosen. 2 fair coins. That is, sample space becomes HH, HT, TH, TT. Okay, HH, HT, THT. If both are heads, earn 1 is chosen. That is, when 2 heads are obtained, earn 1 is chosen. Then what happens? If both are tails, earn 2 is chosen. That is, when 2 tails are obtained, earn 2. Otherwise, earn 3 is chosen means, if a head is obtained, that is, either HT or TH obtained, earn 3 is chosen. Otherwise, earn 3 is chosen. So, these urns are chosen according as either 2 heads are obtained or 2 tails are obtained or 2 or 1 head, that means HT or TH are obtained. respectively. Okay, that is P of A1 is 1 by 4, P of A2 is 1 by 4 and P of A3 is 2 by 4. Okay. Now, what is the probability that otherwise N3 is chosen? After an urn is chosen, 3 marbles are picked at random from it. After an urn is chosen, 3 marbles are picked at random from it. What is the probability that all the 3 are black? What is the probability that all the 3 are black? Then, we want to find urn 3 was chosen if all the 3 marbles are black. That is, under the condition that all the 3 marbles are black, what is the probability of choosing urn 3? That is the problem. Okay. So, here this is the complete picture and 3 black marbles are drawn. 3 black marbles are drawn. Okay, so let us consider the events. What are the events? There are urn 1, urn 2, urn 3. So that A1 is, urn 1 is chosen, A1 is chosen. That is, what about that is, 2 heads are obtained. 2 heads are obtained. So, symbol to obtain the probability of N1. Okay. Out of the sample space, that is 4 outcomes. 2 heads means probability of A1 equal to 1 by 4. Okay. And A2 means N2 is chosen. N2 is chosen. That is, N2 is chosen. Clearly, it is mentioned that if both are tails, N2 is chosen. That is, once again, verify this one. That is, 2 tails, that means probability again 1 by 4. Okay. And E3 is N3. N3 is chosen. That is, either HT or TH. That is, 1H. Either HT or TH. That is, 1H. So, and B has 3 black marbles are drawn. 3 black marbles are drawn and required to find P of B. Required to find P of B and P of B and P of under B given B or 3 means A3. That is P of A3 given B. This is obtained, P of B is obtained using the total probability rule and the conditional probability by Bayes theorem. Okay. So, let us move on to this probability. That is, we have P of A1 as equal to HH. Complete picture of the problem is given here. Okay. So, that P of A1 as equal to P of HH. So, equal to 1 by 4. P of A2 as equal to P of TT. So, again equal to 1 by 4. P of A3 as equal to P of HT or TH. So, equal to 2 by 4. Isn't it? Now, P of B given even. Means that P of B given A1 under A1, that is from urn 1, 3 black marbles. So, what about 3 black marbles out of this one? Okay. So, that 4C3 divided by 10 plus 8, 16 plus 4, 20. 4C3 divided by 20C3, it is equal to 4 by 1140, which is 0.004. Okay, P of E1, P of B given E1 is 0.004 and P of B given E2, that is under A2 means from urn 2, what about 12 white, 4 red and 4 black, that is again 4C3 divided by, what is the total, 12 plus 4, 16 plus 4, 20C3. 4C3 divided by 20C3, so that it is equal to, again, it is equal to 4 by 1140, that is 0.004. Now P of B given A3. P of B given A3 as equal to P of B given A3 as equal to from on 3. That is, there are 5 black balls. So 5C3 divided by 8 plus 7, 15 plus 5, 20C3. 5C3 divided by 20C3, so it is equal to 0.009. Okay, that is by total probability rule, P of B equal to sigma I equal to 1 to 3 P of EI into P of B given EI. So equal to what about 1 by 4 into 0.004 plus 1 by 4 into 0.004. That is P of A1 into P of B given A1 plus P of A2 into P of B given A2 plus P of A3 2 by 4 into P of B given A3 0.009, and it is equal to 0.0065. Okay, now let us obtain P of, what is the case, P of A3 given B. Okay, P of A3 given B by Bayes theorem. P of A3 given B equal to P of A3 intersection B, which is P of A3 into P of B given A3 divided by P of B, isn't it? P of B, that is the total probability P of B. So that we get this as P of A3 is 2 by 4 into P of B given A3 is 0.009 divided by 0.0065. Let me write. That is P of A3 given B equal to P of A3 is 2 by 4 into P of B given A3 is 0.009 divided by P of B is 0.0065, and hence the answer is 0.049. Okay, so we obtain the conditional probability P of A3 given B using Bayes theorem. This is the end of the base, the entire section probability. Okay, probability full topic eduthu kaynu adile kore problems cheydu Bayes theorem kore ella variety problems cheydu. Okay, examination point view almost ellam cover idu nanu ende vishwasam. So nannayittu padikkan ellavarkum pattatte. Okay, all the best wishes. Thank you very much.